Well, there is no sweetness between local sugar producers and the Sugar Regulatory Administration right now over plans to import some 200,000 metric tons of the commodity. The price of bee sugar, which is meant for domestic market, has gone up some 16% from September last year. Joining us this morning to represent the Philippine Chamber of Food Manufacturers is Ms. Helen Grace Baisa. Helen, thank you so much for taking our call this morning.
Thank you so much, Mimi, for giving us the opportunity to speak on behalf of the chamber.
All right, so let's start with this. Senator Aimee Marcos a few weeks ago claimed that the importation of more refined sugar is being pushed by, and I want to quote her, a major soft drinks manufacturer and processors of sugar products. Minus the lobbying that we're seeing, do you agree that importing sugar is necessary at this point? If you do, why?
Okay, well, the Philippine Chamber of Food Manufacturers, first and foremost, or the food chamber, fully supports the SRA in permitting the importation of 200,000 metric tons of refined sugar by the food manufacturers for this crop year 2021 to 2022. Due to the current local shortage of refined sugar that conforms with the specifications or quality requirements of food manufacturers, particularly premium and butler's grade refined sugar, there is an urgent need for importation. So,
Helen, you made a distinction. You require premium sugar.
Yes.
How would you define premium sugar versus raw sugar versus refined sugar?
Okay, basically these premium sugar are crystalline white sugar, free from foreign materials, free from those black specifications. And those are normally the ones that we use in milk powder production and other food manufacturing products. So, you know, it's different from the one that we actually take. So, you know, on a regular basis. So these have very low moisture content because first and foremost, we use this in powder products, for instance, which of course we have to make sure that the end product is not hygroscopic. So hygroscopicity also plays a big role.
And do we produce refined premium sugar? How much do we produce locally?
Well, locally, I think out of the we only seven refineries can produce this premium grade sugar.
Okay, and how much are they producing versus what's the deficit? How much do you need? How much do the manufacturers need?
Okay, just for the record, the stocks will be exhausted this month. So there are, again, there are more than 20 raw sugar mills in the country, but only seven refineries produce refined sugar. And out of this number, only four are able to supply the major food manufacturers. So these suppliers have informed our members that Typhoon Odette, aside from destroying crops last year, damaged refineries and refined stocks. So local sugar supply was highly affected. And more so, these refineries that were hit stopped production for a month until power was restored. So plus the lack of available containers and the congestion at the ports of Bacolod and Manila further made the sugar situation worse. So.
So these mills that are able to produce the premium sugar had to shut down because of the typhoon, and you're saying they had to close down for a month, not a week, which is being claimed by some groups.
No, for a month. Yes, for a month.
And these millers are in the regions of Negros, Panay, and Eastern Visayas, correct?
Yes, yes.
All right. Just to clarify, what is the deficit that you're looking at? You say that our current stocks are going to be exhausted by this month. This is stocks for the year, will be exhausted by this month?
Yes.
If we don't import?
Yes, this March.
Okay, so the 200,000 metric tons of this would be premium sugar.
Should be premium sugar, yes.
Okay, this will be enough to plug the deficit.
Yes, that should be enough to plug the deficit.
And yes, go ahead.
Yeah, please.
Go ahead.
We just wanted this on an emergency case. We fully support the local sugar industry And, you know, it's easier, in fact, for the food industry to purchase on a local basis. Logistic-wise, it is easier for us. Again, materials should, however, be compliant to our required specification.
So you've got that an emergency case, the 200,000 that the government plans to import. Normally, they come from what countries?
Okay, from Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, and Vietnam.
Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, and Vietnam.
Yes.
Last year, how much did we import, if we imported at all?
I don't really have the exact figures at the moment.
But we also imported. So we import every year. Is that accurate? We've been importing every year to plug the deficit?
Every time we actually have deficit, that's the only time we import or we need to import.
Mm-hmm. And the 200,000 that the government SRA plans to import right now is going to last us for the whole year or just a certain period of time before the local millers can catch up because they're back open?
Well, yes. In fact, we're already waiting for the local millers to come back and produce this. But I think for now, the food industry is good with 200,000 metric tons.
For now. Okay. I wanted to look, just give the audience, the viewers, a big picture here. Law of supply and demand for sugar, not necessarily premium, but refined and raw sugar. I think we have graphics of this. When you look at the supply, we've been pretty much steady at 2.1 million metric tons of raw sugar produced every year in the last two crop years. We're seeing red underlines there. Also noticeable, the blue underlines is how the land area used for sugar production has consistently been shrinking from 421,000 hectares in 2016 to just 399,000 in 2021. So essentially, it doesn't seem like production is going to get a boost. Do you expect that we will be importing more on a regular basis just to meet growing demand?
Well, I am hoping not, that we don't import on a regular basis. Today, we foresee a deficit of 300,000 metric tons of sugar in the market due to low crop yield and high demand. So on top of that, there is a lack of sugar industrial standard, as mentioned earlier, which is putting us in a very tight supply situation. So local suppliers are limiting offers as well and asking prices close to 56 pesos per kilo for deliveries in April and May. So, you know, that 300,000 metric tons of sugar we were given, the SRA has actually is allowing us to import 200,000, right? So I think with this, definitely after quite some time, the local producers will be able to catch up. So
to fill the remaining 100,000 deficit.
Yes.
All right. What sort of impact will this have on prices? Importing premium sugar, how will that impact the finished product once you manufacture the food products?
We have observed that sugar retail prices in consumer markets have risen sharply as a result of increased local demand. So based on the latest SRA data, the average price of refined sugar in the first week of February was 3,221.50 per 50 kilogram bag, which is up to 25% from the previous year's price of 2,664.50. So, yeah. So on the other hand, the best estimated global price for fine sugar is 1,650 per 50 kilogram bag.
Okay. So essentially, when the price of sugar goes up, the finished product also, the price will have to go up. And it's going to add inflationary pressure.
Yes, I'm afraid so too.
You know, Helen, it's really the same battle cry that we hear from rice farmers and hog racers. You know, they worry that flooding the market with imported commodities will hurt their prices and squeeze margins. And not only that, because many of our local producers, I imagine, cannot compete in pricing because the cost of producing in the Philippines is just too high, much higher. I mean, if you look at rice, just for rice, the cost of producing rice here is over 12 pesos. The cost of producing the same rice of actually even better quality in Vietnam is just 6 pesos, half. And in Thailand is about 8 pesos. So how, what's in it for the local producers? Can they compete, I guess?
Well, I think that's where actually we need our government support. So for us, local food manufacturers, we will definitely, like we prefer, we would prefer to buy local. You know, I myself, I was raised by the sugar industry. So yes, it's very close to my heart. But I think it's we really need to improve and support our local farmers. And, yeah, capacitate the refineries here. So.
Mm-hmm. Because Helen, you're part of Charmant Ingredients Company. I know that you have operations not just in the Philippines, but you're actually a global company. How when you compare notes with other heads from other Charmant units in other regions of the world, how is the Philippines faring?
Actually, right now, we've also been affected by the global pandemic. So, but we're way better compared to our other Asian countries. Ah, yes.
Really? Okay. And you know, it's not just, yeah, go ahead.
Sorry, but please take note that Charmant doesn't use sugar in the formulations. We're more into nutraceuticals. So.
Yes, I was going there. It's not just sugar, but commodities. In general, the things you use to make food ingredients have been on a super cycle, further fueled by the Russia-Ukraine crisis. Soft commodities, which include wheat, for example, corn, palm oil, all hitting all-time highs. How are food manufacturers coping?
Actually, it's kind of difficult for the food manufacturers. And it's been like this since the onset of the pandemic. The logistics cost, the shipping cost actually increased to like 4 times compared to pre-pandemic. And, you know, the food industry has been absorbing or trying to absorb all the cost from the raw materials, which of course has increased. And apparently the, you know, the logistics cost. But, you know, we can only absorb much, you know, so we have no choice really, but to increase also and pass this on to the consumers. So we're hopeful though that everything will turn out better this year. So, but apparently we are really affected, highly affected. Oh,
final question. Are you confident that things will get better this year?
Well, I think so. I believe so too. You know, we are now on level one. So businesses are opening. So economy would definitely like improve. So yes.
All right. And on that optimistic note, Helen, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Great
thank
speaking
you
with
so
you.
Much. Thank you so much, Mimi.